You that are joining with us this beautiful day. You know the old saying, nothing happens until someone makes it happen. Nothing happens until someone makes it happen. You see, life is filled with choices. If we don't make the decision, then life makes the decision for us. Jesus said, you have not because you ask not. In other words, if you don't ask, you'll have to settle for whatever you get. Many times, life can deal some very crushing blows. In fact, it can knock you to your knees. Sobola makasanta. Yes, life can be very hurtful. Life can be very hateful. Life can be very discouraging and even at times depressing. And it can knock you to your knees. I'm not talking about getting on your knees and praying. I'm talking about life can knock the wind out of your sails. It can knock the wind out of your lungs to where you're coughing and it's hard to even get your breath. Where I come, when my floor director points at me and tells me I'm on the air, I've risen up early in the mornings and prayed. Honest to God as my witness, the presence of God comes upon me. You know, I don't premeditate a lot of what I'm going to say. Might have a few scriptures or something. But right now, I am being saturated in the presence of God. Thank you, Jesus. I'm called for a time such as this. God has placed such faith in my heart. I mean, it's like I leave this studio and I come right there to you. I know I don't physically. But by the power of the Holy Spirit, I'm a gift. The power of God, the Holy Spirit, the anointing, the presence of God comes upon me. And just as I came on the air and I began to talk, I felt the presence of God coming upon me. And when I begin to unpremeditated talk about how life can knock you to your knees, I saw a person watching me on television who life has just absolutely hit you, slugged you, hurt you, knocked you down, and you're having a hard time. That's a tongue, see? I'm speaking from my spirit. I'm not talking from my head. It's like I'm experiencing the presence of Christ reaching out to you to help you. I'm sent to you by God with a word from the Lord. Sometimes when you're knocked down, you need someone to help you get back up. But life is strong. And when you tried to get back up on your own, you need someone greater than yourself. You need the power. There it is. The resurrection power of Christ. You see, I know that I'm mocked, ridiculed, written about, laughed about, even bumper stickers made about me. But how can I look at this camera with such boldness? Such bravery and courage, because it's not I. I've been crucified with Christ. I gave my reputation away a long time ago. But according to Galatians 2:20, nevertheless I live. You're looking at me. Nevertheless I live, yet not I. I'm quoting to you Galatians 2:20, but it's Christ that lives on the inside of me, inside my hands, inside my eyes, inside my ears, to where I hear. I saw a person knocked to his knees by some kind of crushing blow of life. It's not I, but the life that I now live. I live by the faith of the Son of God, the life I live in the flesh. I live by the faith of the Son of God who loved me and gave his life for me. God has sent me to you today the same way he sent Elijah to a woman whose life, kabasoto da basata, there's another word, had fallen apart, whose life, I know I've pulled your file. See, it's the gifts of the Spirit talking through me. Word of wisdom, word of knowledge, discernment, gifts of healing, working of miracles, tongues, interpretation of tongues, and prophecy. 1 Corinthians 12, what the Bible can do today. Today, right now, God is. God's right now. And he sent me to break the demon powers of hell off of you. I feel this. The presence of God in my life, it's like faith. One puts 1,000 to flight, but two puts 10,000 demons of hell to flight. Years ago, God, the Lord Jesus, spoke to me in an audible voice and told me to pray the prayer of agreement, to agree with you in prayer. I don't know who you are, but I know you're there. I know you're there. And I know the Lord is endeavoring to speak through me to you. I want to pray and minister to you. In a moment, I'm going into my special place of prayer that I've dedicated and consecrated to pray for you in my chapel, my miracle prayer chapel. I'm going to get down on my knees. And I want to lay my hand on your prayer request. I want you to call me at 214-620-6200. My prayer minister will answer the phone. And as many of the prayer requests that I can possibly pray for, I'm going to pray for them in my chapel. But I know that I know that I know that I know at this moment there's a person watching me that has a need. And God has sent me to bring his power, into your life to help you, to heal you, to help you get back on your feet. In just a moment, I'm going to go into my chapel. I want you to call me, and when you do, be sure and ask for my book. It's free, entitled God's Miracle Plan for Man. You need this book. Just take a moment. Thank you, Lord. Just a call. Just take a moment for you to call. Thank you, Jesus. Sometimes when I'm talking prophetically and the power of God's moving people, they don't call because they don't want to miss a word. But right now, your word is to call. Right now, your word is. Jesus said, you have not because you ask not. Signs follow them that believe. God, the Spirit of the Lord, is upon me. There it is again. Thank you, Jesus. To release this anointing into your life through prayer. I believe this with all of my heart. I'm dedicating my life to helping people. And you are the one today. Don't miss this. This is a word of knowledge for someone. When I came on the air, thank you, Jesus. He just anoints me. It just comes upon me. The hand of God comes upon me to pray. And I saw a person that's hurting today. And I want to pray for you. I want you to quickly call